contest is scheduled for one fall in the ring. Hailing from Chelsea, England, weighing in at 247 pounds, Paul Mitchell.
You know, Katie Lee's not wearing green, Matt. Why don't you go try and pinch her and see what happens?
Katie Lee's like the girl next door, provided you live next to a haunted castle. Hornswoggle and Finley out cavorting and celebrating this holiday known as St. Patrick's Day. Little history, of course, St. Patrick's Day is used to commemorate the day that St. Patrick drove the snakes out of Ireland. Technically, snakes don't really exist in Ireland. It's just symbolism.
That's because they drove them out, that's why.
The serpents represented paganism, but whatever.
Either way, the Ides of March are upon us as Finley gets ready to face Paul Burchill.
You know what the Ides of March are about?
The Ides in the month of March.
It's the date.
Very timely.
The date that Julius Caesar was assassinated. All right, he declared himself dictator for life.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Katie Lee looking on as Paul Burchill, tired of corned beef and cabbage, gets set to take on Finley.
Oh, of course, Finley competing in the Money in the Bank ladder match come the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania. But before Finley can go there, Finley must deal with the Ripper, Paul Burchill.
Burchill has a very in-your-face type style as well as Finley. How do you outfight Finley?
Kind of like trying to find a bicycle in the basement of the Alamo. It's just not possible. I mean, Burchill will come up with some skullduggery, I assure you.
Well, you can't wrestle like Pee Wee Herman and hope to get a win here against Finley. I took what you said and brought it forward. Finley going shoulders down. And
hi, how you doing?
Ladies and gentlemen, Hornswoggle is here.
Okay, having a good time. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Hornswoggle, Finley's son. What do you know? You can't have my headset. I need to tell the WWE Universe about the...
father wants you.
Yeah, no, no.
Do you speak leprechaun?
I don't, even though I'm very sure.
Over the top rope.
Okay, go away now. You smell like Frankfurters. Thank you. Okay, never know what to expect here on ECW. There's that skullduggery as Paul Burchill seems to be working on the back of Finley.
You know, we laugh about Hornswoggle, but is he sometimes more of a hindrance to his father than a help?
You'd have to ask Finley that question. You know, he's a leprechaun, basically.
Or so we believe.
Burchill smart here, applying the pressure. That rear chin lock cuts off the flow of air and oxygen to the brain, makes it hard to breathe, hard to think. If anyone can get out of it, it's going to be Finley.
Well, it's tough to beat Finley on any day of the year, but on St. Patrick's Day, it's got to be darn near impossible.
Well, Todd, a long history. Hang on.
Shoulders down, leg is hooked.
Between the English and the Irish.
Yeah, Northern Ireland and England get along about as well as Tom and Jerry.
Who?
Is that what you're gonna say, something like that? I tried to beat you to the punch every once in a while.
Keep trying, pal. Keep trying.
Tom and Jerry, that he's trying.
That's great. Now notice here how Burchill's legs are spread apart. That keeps the pressure down, but Finley applying his head. And it seems to be the opportunity that the Irishman needs.
Burchill not backing down at all. Are you surprised at the Englishman's tactics here so far? Just when things were going so right, Finley turns them wrong for Paul Burchill.
Wow, talk about using your tools. That is the experience of the Fighting Irishman, Finley, and here he goes.
The Belfast Brawler has taken this match by the scruff of its neck and is not letting go.
What would it be like with Finley? Whoa, smart. What if Finley has access to a ladder? Think about what that's gonna be like come WrestleMania.
Right now, Finley doesn't need a ladder. All he needs is that maneuver. Finley on St. Patrick's Day. Cheerio.
Aaron Gobra, my friend. The celebration continues as Katie Lee picks cabbage out of her hair. Finley and his befuddled son, Hornswoggle. And I guess that's what it's really all about, huh? Having a good time no matter what day of the year it is. Here's what happened at the end here. Finley just smart enough to get out of the way as Burchill went for the neckbreaker. And then the Celtic Cross, the Emerald Fusion, that spells defeat. Imagine if Finley hits that on, say, Kofi Kingston off the ladder come WrestleMania. Finley could be the Money in the Bank ladder match winner.
So corned beef and cabbage get settled in the ring. Finley your winner, Irish Eyes smiling on St. Patrick's Day as the Irishman beats